So Charles, I kind of cheated.
Oh, tell me more.
So Q-learning isn't really an algorithm. Q-learning is actually a family of algorithms. There's lots of different reinforcement learning algorithms, specific reinforcement learning algorithms that can be reasonably called Q-learning. And they vary typically along these three dimensions. How do we initialize our estimate, Q-hat? How do we decay our learning rates, alpha sub t? And how do we choose actions during learning? And different ways of making these choices actually lead to algorithms with fairly different behaviors. In particular, when we use this in the context of an MDP, let me ask you. So, like, what do you think might matter about? Let's start with the last one: choosing actions.
There's a bunch of dumb things you could do, right? You could just pick an action every single time, like the same action every single time, independent of what you've learned. That's kind of dumb. But it seems like the obvious smart thing to do is say, look, I'm learning, I'm getting better and better. So what I'm going to do is at this next time step, since I have to actually take an action, I'll just pick the action that my Q hat tells me is the best action to take. And I'm done.
So, all right, well, let me see if I can capture some of what you just said there. So one way to choose actions really badly is, say, pick some action, call it A sub zero, and no matter what state you're in, no matter what's happened so far, always choose that action.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So this can't possibly work. It is going to violate the Q-learning convergence that says that we have to visit each state action pair infinitely often and update them to converge. And, you know, and it makes perfect sense. Like, if we never try something, like, how do you know that you don't like something if you've never even tried it?
Like spinach.
Exactly. Another idea would be to choose randomly. And this seems kind of good in that we are going to visit, you know, all the states that are visitable, and we will try all the actions that are actionable. And we could actually learn Q this way. But as you pointed out, this is not a great idea because we may have learned Q, but we haven't really used it. We haven't really chosen actions using what we've learned. So it's like we're wise, but we are impotent.
I think it's more like we're wise, but we're stupid. I mean,
we're wise, but we know a lot, but we refuse to actually do anything about it.
Right, and in particular, in some sense, there's the only difference between the two is the theorem, right? If I'm just choosing randomly, so what's the problem with always choosing A sub zero? Well, you aren't going to converge. But the real problem is you don't learn anything, or you don't take advantage of anything you learn. Choosing randomly is the same thing. You basically never take advantage of anything that you learn. What's the point of learning a Q function if you're always going to behave randomly? You've learned nothing, or you've learned, but you. Actually,
right, you've learned, but it has it. Right, you've learned. You actually learned the optimal policy, but you're not following it. So you're not actually using what you know. So you can't. It doesn't work. All right. So then you had another idea, which was to use our estimate to choose actions.
Yeah.
And that seems like a good idea, in that we will use it. Is it possible that it won't learn?
Well, it'll learn something.
Well, yeah, it might not learn anything all that good, though. So, for example, what if we do something like this? So we initialize, now we're back up to this first point here, we initialize the estimate Q hat so that for every state, A0 looks awesome and all the other actions look terrible.
Wait, is that metric awesome or English awesome?
Oh, I'm sorry, you're right. I didn't put units on that. That's in Chilean dollars.
Oh, okay, so it's pretty awesome then. Okay, so if you do that, then... Well, let's see what happens. So it's almost like always taking A0. The only thing that would save you from taking A0 forever is if, as you take A0, you learn that you update your cues and you keep getting really, really bad results. Really, really bad results. In fact, worse than terrible.
Ah, yes. Well, let's imagine that terrible is worse than terrible.
Oh.
So, but you're right. Yeah, you're right. There's at least the case that if this terrible value is actually lower than the value of always choosing A0, then it will continue to choose A0 forever. This is called the greedy action selection strategy.
Mm-hmm.
And that this is the problem that runs into it. It's a kind of local min.
Oh, I see. Okay, I see now. So you didn't even have to come up with this ridiculous example. Extreme example.
I was going to say, I'm sorry, ridiculous how?
Well, I'm sorry. It's a ridiculous situation to be in. It's sort of the extremely unlucky example.
I think what you're saying is that you don't like people from Chile.
Oh, no, I love people from Chile. I love Chile, especially with some good beans and some nice meat. But the thing is that if you randomly set your Q hat in such a way that a bad action, or let's say a suboptimal action, ends up looking much better to begin with in the optimal action, you can get in a situation where you'll keep choosing the wrong action anyway, and so you're only going to learn things that reinforce that action, which might be good, just not optimal. And so you won't actually end up converging onto the true QHAT, and that's how you'll get into a local min.
That's right. And so in that bad situation, and I admit it is a little contrived, because I've never even been to Chile, is that it won't learn. It'll actually be exactly the same as this first case, always choose a sub-zero.
Mm-hmm.
So that seems problematic too. And it interacts in an interesting way with the initialization, right? So maybe we can do this idea of using QHAT, but we have to be much more careful about how we initialize.
So, you know, what I want to do is something like random restarts.